The life protest is going on right here at the Nigerian Embassy in New York City. New York City, peaceful protest.
Yes.
The people are tired of corruption, yes, and they're saying no to oppression. Right now we're on the move and just getting started. The people are right here united and singing our solidarity songs. The demands are simple.
Our lives of them, our accounts all over the foreign countries.
have billions of dollars saved in foreign countries. It is high time we need to check them. It is high time we need to ask them to be accountable. It is high time we need to tell them that Nigerians are no longer fools. It is high time we need to let them know that Nigeria is a great nation. It is high time we need to let them know that we cannot accept the bullshit anymore. Say no to corruption.
No.
Say no to bad leadership.
No.
Say no to idiots in the government. We are tired of them and we want to take this country to be accountable for everything that is happening. The killings that are happening in Lagos,
in Lagos
and other parts of the country, we have to be accountable for this. The leadership have to be accountable for the killings of our young people. They have to be accountable for the killings of the young people in Nigeria. Now, it is high time we needed to do something. Because if you do not do something, they will do worse to your own children. They have done it with our parents. Our parents were gentle. They were not bold to confront them. But this generation is saying no.
No,
no. No to bad leadership.
No.
No to bad governance
no.
In Nigeria.
No.
Enough is enough.
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 Enough. Enough.
Enough. Enough.
Enough. Enough. Enough. Enough.
Yes,
Nigeria.
Yes.
We have to end, put end to the legislators.
Yes.
Legislators, one man is earning 35 million in a month.
Yes.
Enough is enough.
Enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough
is enough.
Enough.
Stop.
Yes.
This must stop. We are marching forward. We are marching forward. The corruption is just too much in Nigeria.
Yes.
And we have to stop it.
Yes.
We have to stop it. And all the children of the politicians, the elected officers, they have to be banned from coming overseas to study.
Exactly.
Yes. Exactly. We have to ban them. Nigeria is great. We are blessed in the whole world. Nigeria is blessed. But we have come to nothing in the country. God will punish all of them.
Amen.
God will punish all of them.
Amen. They are very peaceful, singing the national anthem and the military out. When we are killing our youth, what have they done? They want change. They want change. They want change. We want change. We want change in Nigeria. We want change. Enough. Enough is enough. Enough. Today I am dedicating my birthday to them. Why should they be killing our youth? Why would they be killing our youth? They were protesting for change. They did nothing. They did nothing. They were protesting for change. These leaders don't want change because of what they're doing. The Hamas are on them. They're pushing to freeze back. They're saving. They're putting somewhere all the COVID relief. They did not share to the people. Why? Why would you amass all the wealth for yourself alone? And the youth are suffering. The youth will graduate 4 years, 7 years in the universities. They will come out no work. They will even try to be entrepreneurs. Tax will kill them and say, they are criminals. Tattoo does not mean that you're a criminal. Getting your ears does not show you're a criminal. Pressing nicely. Does not mean you are a criminal.
Hey.
Stop killing our youth.
Stop.
Who are you? It's not right. Do something.
Dead already, man. We all know that.
Where is dead?
Guys, it's happening live right here. We are right here.
We raise our voice.
Yes.
That is our only weapon.
Yes,
wherever they are.
Yes.
The judgment of God.
Yes.
Shall come upon their life.
Amen.
Every tongue.
Yes.
That had promised that Nigeria will not witness me. All over their generation.
Yes, sir.
They will not witness me.
Yes, sir. Alright guys, this is a fight for everybody, a fight for everyone and by everyone. The Nigerian people right here are saying no to bad governance, saying no to bad governors, saying no to oppression and all kinds and all form of oppression. And that's what we are doing right here. So Nigerians, you are not alone. You are not alone.
Nigeria is a fucking blessed country.
And I mean, I can't imagine how these people walk on the streets of Nigeria, like having millions of dollars in their pocket, and they're walking on the street when the roads are not fixed. I mean, I would say this government is not so wicked. They are stupid.
No water.
Nigeria.
No.
Create a new one. We need a new Nigeria. 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 End SARS. End police brutality. End border. Change wickedness to love.
Yes.
We need a new Nigeria.
Yes.
We need new people.
Yes.
We need people that understand the beauties of life.
Yes.
This niggas love money than they love itself.
Yes.
No.
They've threaded their life, their souls. They don't give a shit about anybody anymore. If you're not one of them, you're nobody.
Yes.
So we need a new Nigeria.
Yes.
Say no to Buhari.
No.
Say no to bad governance.
No.
We need a new Nigeria.
Yes. Go, go, Father is
there. Arise, Bomba
Trump, Nigeria's followed him to serve our father's land with love and strength and faith. The labor of our heroes past shall never be.
We have to reason our life. We have to, you know.
put down a plan, because if you fail to plan, you will plan to fail. So that is why we have to do the right thing. That is why we are educated. That is why we have to prove to them that this position that you guys are, as a young people, we also can be there. How can we exercise our right? It's by contesting. We have to be in the political system. We have to contest for governor. We have to contest for presidency. So we as a youth, and I'm employing everybody, we have to face now that we are
here.
Now we have to let them know that we are working. Nothing can make us go back.